Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. My name is Nalo, and today we're going to be talking about the general TF2 unusual crash that just happened in the overall economy for all Valve games, and how this market crash actually is going to affect CSGO and other games. And also we're going to be talking about the precedent that this sets and how Valve is going to respond to these in the future. So with that being said, guys, let's get straight into the video. But before we get into the video, I did want to say a couple things. First of all, the project that I've been working on is going to be out in about 2 days from now, I'm hoping. And I kind of had to push it back a little bit just because it's being really weird and there's a lot of issues with it. But hopefully that does end up being really awesome once it does come out. And hopefully these videos sort of tide you over until then. And the second thing I wanted to say is I do have a Discord server and a Twitter. You can find both of those links in the description below. And hopefully those do help you with your investments in the future. There's a really great community over there, so come on in and say hi to everybody, and hopefully you enjoy your stay. So guys, thank you so much for watching, and now let's actually get into the video. So I guess the first thing I should do is actually explain what did happen with the unusual crash, and kind of what led up to it, and what caused it, because I think there are some people watching that aren't going to know, just because this is a recent event. So guys, let's talk about that first. So the first thing that happened in this timeline of events was the Ricardo hat being added to Team Fortress 2. This was a really huge celebration, and a lot of people were really happy that this had finally happened, just because it was kind of like a meme to come true. And a lot of people were just really enjoying TF2 and enjoying the fact that update had actually occurred. But what had happened under the scenes of this new Ricardo hat being added to TF2 was something much more sinister in the form of the economic crash. So it's not actually confirmed what has directly happened, but all the really important information is that when they were doing some bug fixes for the game, they accidentally increased the unusual rates in a few of the cases, the older ones at least, to be 100%, so people could actually go and automatically unbox unusuals. And unusuals being probably the hallmark of the TF2 economy, one of the most expensive items in general, and also being one of the highest quantified items in the TF2 economy, caused a huge crash, and a lot of the items decreased in price, just the unusual specifically. And so basically the unusual price crashed and case prices skyrocketed, and that's the general information that you need to know. The cases that did increase specifically are not really relevant, just because this problem has actually kind of been patched by now, but in general that is what happened. And let's get into talking about the actual economic effects of this. So based on how my Discord has actually reacted to this situation, I've seen that a lot of people don't really understand the implications that it has for the CSGO economy specifically. A lot of people thought that because so much money was being made from people selling cases, that they'd be able to decrease the price of other items on the market, just because they'd be able to flood the market with more CSGO items. That is not the case though. The opposite is actually true. Because people have more money and they're spending it on other games like CSGO or like Dota, because a lot of people who, you know, didn't play TF2 and played other games, they actually took the money they made from TF2 just because they might have played it in the past and then bought other cases and other games and other skins with that money. So what ended up happening is a lot of these skins and other games, like I know for example, I'm going to talk about the AK-47 Empress, those prices actually increased because of the main problem of rarity. So people were kind of making the items artificially more rare by buying them with the money that they gained from this glitched case. So I actually own an AK-47 Empress, and what I noticed is that over the course of this whole entire thing happening, my AK Empress went from about $43 in price to about $50 in price, so it raised about $7, and that's a really significant change, especially for the Empress, considering it's a covert skin that is not traded significantly enough to actually increase the value of it to around $50, but that did actually happen. And there's a lot of other skins across the market that the same kind of change was paralleled in, so it's kind of interesting to see that the CSGO market was actually affected in such a huge way with just the TF2 market being manipulated. So I don't really want to waste your time talking about random skins that you probably don't care about, so I'm going to just say in general that a lot of these skins that rose in price are going to be the more in-demand skins, like the AK-47 Empress and the Red Line and stuff like that, and obviously the rarer skins are going to rise more, because the rarer that a skin is, the more easily it is manipulated by stuff like this in the market. So a lot of the CSGO skins are up right now. I would say that if you have one of these skins that was manipulated up, do kind of take advantage of it and try to sell it and make a little bit more profit than you usually would on the skin. And that's kind of the advice that I would give you right now, just because it looks like this whole thing is going to shut down after this weekend ends. So guys, that's going to do it for the second topic of this video. Let's now talk about the final thing in this video, which is the precedent this sets. So we actually saw about an entire day of manipulation before TF2 devs and, you know, Valve devs actually came in and decided to stop this whole thing. So I do want to say that in the future, if something like this were to happen, we could see a much bigger economic crash for a game. For example, maybe if this happened in CSGO for whatever reason, maybe cases started automatically dropping knives. If that actually did end up happening, I think that in CSGO specifically, that might actually be fixed faster just because the team is a little bit bigger than the TF2 team. And so the response time and, you know, figuring out that, you know, how to fix this problem is going to happen a lot faster than it did in TF2. I will say, though, that if this does happen in CSGO, the response to it is going to be a lot worse just because the CSGO economy is a lot more vibrant than the TF2 economy, you know, despite the TF2 economy being so big at one point. So I think for the general precedent, I think for other games, if something like this does happen, we can see a lot of manipulation before the effects of it actually get resolved. And I think that it does depend on the size of the dev team in terms of when the fix is actually going to happen. Now going forward, let's talk about that. And by going forward, I mean what is going to happen after the weekend ends, what's going to happen to people who bought the cases and stuff like that, since that's kind of in the gray area right now. I will say right now that you don't have to be worried about being trade banned for engaging in this at all. This was completely Valve's fault and it was completely the TF2 dev's fault. Just because you took advantage of it doesn't mean that it is your fault in any way. There are a lot of people that just maybe came into the market new and they don't have any access to new sources and they didn't know specifically what was happening to unusual prices. You know, maybe they could have thought that there was just a sale going on and so they ended up buying some unusuals for cheaper prices just because they were, you know, ones that they wanted. And so for that reason alone, we can very confidently say that Valve is not going to trade ban you or anything like that just for taking advantage of this. You're not using any sort of third-party program to kind of exploit the market. All you're doing is taking advantage of one of their mistakes, and it is their fault entirely for this happening, so you don't have to worry about being trade banned. In the rare case that you are trade banned, I know that some devs in other games, you know, usually do trade ban for this kind of thing. We know Valve, you know, not to do this, but I will say, in the general sense of things, if trade ban actually does happen, don't be worried that it will be rolled back very quickly. Millions of people took advantage of this, and it's going to be way too big of a deal. If they do actually trade ban people for this, they're going to lose a ton of money and a ton of subscribers, and it's not something that they want to do. So I don't think you have to be worried about trade banning at all. As for getting market locked, I guess it is, there were some people getting market locked just because the overall volume of stuff that they were selling on the market was huge. I don't know if that actually has lasted throughout the day or if it has been taken off. I know it's an automated system, so you don't really, if you did actually have that happen to you and it's still going on, don't worry, that'll probably be fixed in the future very soon, so you don't have to worry about being locked out of your account or locked out of the market. And I guess to sum up, another question that people were having is there going to be a cheater's lament given out? I don't know, that's actually totally up to them. The cheater's lament is kind of a weird one where, you know, you don't really understand how it's going to be given out and how the, you know, if it's actually going to be given out at all. I do think that it won't be given out just because the last time a cheater's lament was given out, that was actually for a third-party exploit and not for a glitch on their own part. So I don't think a cheater's lament is actually going to be given out for this, but we might see some sort of, you know, interesting investable hat that will be commemorating this sort of weird market decrease. As for the future of the unusual market and the future of the TF2 market, things actually do look pretty bright. I think they have a lot of options, for example, market rollbacks and stuff like that, where they can just give you back the cases and the keys that you previously sold and refund balances and stuff like that. If they do something like that, then the TF2 market will probably stabilize in the future. I do think that this will have some sort of a negative effect on it, but I don't think it'll be too massive. I think with people kind of now understanding that something like this can happen, they'll be a little bit more cautious about investing, and the market might see some sort of a downturn because of that. But other than that, I think in general, the market is going to be fine for TF2 going forward, so we don't have to worry about that. And with all of that being said, that pretty much sums up this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, be sure to leave a like on this video and consider subscribing for more content like this. I'll be having a lot more videos coming out in the future, and the future of this channel looks bright, I guess. And yeah, thanks for all the support. I will see you all next time. Peace.